话说一天晚饭后，有这么一家15口决定出门溜达溜达，结果溜达大发了，都上新闻了，我们一起关注一下。
A wandering herd of elephants has reached the edge of a big Chinese city as authorities rush to close off roads and neighborhoods to protect both the animals and people. It's not clear why the 15 elephants made their long trek, which has been documented and monitored both on the ground and from the air by a dozen drones. Authorities have urged people in areas where the elephants have traveled to stay indoors and are blocking roads with construction equipment while seeking to lure the animals away with food. The Xinhua News Agency reported Thursday, the elephants by late Wednesday night had reached the Jinning District on the edge of Kunming, a city of 7 million people that is the capital of Yunnan Province.
What's up, guys? 我是英语调音师 Jerry. Welcome back. 我们先来逐句的把这段新闻看懂。A wandering herd of elephants has reached the edge of a big Chinese city as authorities rush to close off roads and neighborhoods to protect both the animals and people. 我们来看这么几个单词。Wander. 这个词可以翻译作游荡、闲逛或者走神。一块来看例句。
You can't simply wander around.There are rules to follow.
你可不能随便闲逛，这可是有规矩的地儿。在发音上要提醒大家注意区分这两个单词 ：wander（ 闲逛）、wonder（ 惊奇）。这俩词头尾都一样啊，区别在中间的元音上。wander 里面这个 an 要读成 on， 其实和单词 on 在什么东西上面那读音是一样的啊。wander。
Just wander around. All right, don't wander too far.
而 wonder 中间的 on 要读成 an， 实际上和 under 里面那个 an 读法是一样的。Please follow me. An, wonder. 一起来比较一下。Wander. 我们还是尝试把这两个词用到同样一句话里面啊。
I'm wondering why you were wandering around.
我很好奇你在瞎溜达啥呢。
Chances are he'll just wander home and wonder how he got there.
下面一个我们要关注的单词是 herd. Herd 这个词是兽群或者民众的意思。过去这一年里，你应该没少听过 herd immunity 这么个词组。这个词组中文翻译作群体免疫啊。Herd immunity occurs when a large portion of a community becomes immune to a disease.
当一个社群里很大一部分人对某种疾病产生免疫力的时候呢，就算是产生群体免疫了。
The next word is authority. Authority 这个词可以翻译作权力、威信或者当局。这是名词啊，还有这么几个不同的词性，当然咱得知道啊。
Author 名词，作者、发起人。
Authorize 这是动词，批准、授权的意思。我们还是尝试把这几个词都用在同样一个句子里啊。
The author has authorized me to represent him while speaking with the authority.
作者已经授权我来代表他与当局对话。
You're breaking rule number one, questioning my authority.
所以这句话翻译过来是这样的。
A wandering herd of elephants has reached the edge of a big Chinese city.
一群游荡的大象到达了中国一座大城市的边缘。
As authorities rush to close off roads and neighborhoods to protect both the animals and people.
当局急于封锁道路和居民区，以保护动物和人。我们继续。
It's not clear why the 15 elephants made their long trek, which has been documented and monitored both on the ground and from the air by a dozen drones. Authorities have urged people in area where the elephants have traveled to stay indoors and are blocking roads with construction equipment while seeking to lure the animals away with food.
Here are a couple of words you should know.
Trek
这个词是长途旅行或者跋涉的意思。这个既可以是名词，也可以是动词。来看例句啊。
We have to trek up the hill to find food.
我们得长途跋涉，爬上那座山才找得到食物。或者作为名词呢，我们也可以找一个例句。
It's a long trek into town.
要进城啊，咱还得走很远。Here comes the next word.
Monitor.
Monitor 这个单词做名词讲啊，是显示器或者检测器的意思。在原文
，which has been documented and monitored both on the ground and from the air，
这个半句里面呢，做动词是观察或者监视的意思。稍微多说两句啊，不知道您，反正我小时候老师可讲过， 班长这个词儿英语就是 monitor。后来发现啊，其实在北美很少有这么用的。为什么呢？因为在北美大多数的中学里边啊，压根儿就没有咱们上中学那会儿几年几班的这么一建制，所以英语里也就没有完全能够对标班主任、班长之类职位的单词。大家上学都是修学分，您可能数学课和某位同学同班，但是历史课就和他不同班了，因为人家这一年就没修历史。这种松散的模式下，何谈我们概念里的班长呢？我们来把这个话题稍微延展一小下啊。很多人在尝试我们熟悉的中文里的概念时呢，总是想找到一个对标的英语单词。 There's nothing wrong with you trying to do that, but do keep in mind please, some of these common, simple terms in Chinese simply don't exist in English. 如果强行找一个词来对标的话，那么产生歧义就很正常了。其实在翻译方面，我还有不少实用的建议可以给大伙儿。有兴趣听我讲一集的各位，可以在评论里喊一嗓子。 Let's look at the next word, drone.这个词是无人机的意思啊， You most likely already know this. 在1935年，美国海军决定管远程操控的飞行器叫做 drone 以前啊，这个词的主要意思是嗡嗡声或者雄风。这个词咱自己人能读准的不多啊，很多人说的干脆就是河南话，中。Let's deal with this. If you were to break this word down, you will see the following sounds. J, R, U, U, N.What you need to do is to make each and every sound correctly without stopping. Please allow me to demonstrate. Drone. Follow me, please. Drone. Drone. Drone.
It's an Indian surveillance drone.
The next word is lure. Lure.这个词是引诱的意思。来看例句。It is a tool for retailers to lure customers into a shopping trap. 这是个零售商引诱顾客进入购物陷阱的工具。现在我们可以翻译一下了。It's not clear why the 15 elephants made their long trek. 目前还不清楚这15头大象长途跋涉的原因。Which has been documented and monitored both on the ground and from the air by a dozen drones.十几架无人机在地面和空中都记录和监控了这一过程。Authorities have urged people in areas where the elephants have traveled to stay indoors. 当局敦促大象出行地区的人们待在室内。And are blocking roads with construction equipment while seeking to lure the animals away with food. 并用建筑机械封锁道路，同时试图用食物引诱大象离开。我们继续。The Xinhua News Agency reported Thursday, the elephants by late Wednesday night had reached the Jinning district on the edge of Kunming, a city of 7 million people that is the capital of Yunnan province. 我们来看这个单词 district. District. 这个词有地区、街区的意思。一块来看例句。The flood destroyed the whole district. 洪水摧毁了整个地区。Let's look at the next word.Edge 这个单词意思很多啊，作为名词有边缘、锋芒，也有刀刃的意思。作为动词呢，它也可以是慢慢挪动的意思。You most likely have heard of the phrase cutting edge. 这是某种工具上用来切割的利刃，引申出来呢，就是尖端的、前沿的。一块来看例句。This factory is at the cutting edge of manufacturing technology.这家工厂处于制造技术的前沿，所以这最后一句咱得这么翻译。The Xinhua News Agency reported Thursday, 新华社周四报道 The elephants by late Wednesday night had reached the Jinning district on the edge of Kunming. 截至周三深夜，这些大象已经抵达位于昆明市边缘的晋宁区。A city of 7 million people that is the capital of Yunnan province.一个有700万人口的云南省省会城市，大象这一家子算是来了一场世界瞩目的说走就走的旅行。不错啊，人家活的可是比我潇洒多了，贼羡慕。Anyway, that's pretty much all I gotta cover today. Gotta go prepare the next episode now. Don't forget to give us a big like before you leave. 我是英语调音师 Jerry, I'll catch you later. A wandering herd of elephants has reached the edge of a big Chinese city as authorities rush to close off roads and neighborhoods to protect both the animals and people. It's not clear why the 15 elephants made their long trek,
which has been documented and monitored both on the ground and from the air by a dozen drones. Authorities have urged people in areas where the elephants have traveled to stay indoors and are blocking roads with construction equipment while seeking to lure the animals away with food. The Xinhua News Agency reported Thursday the elephants by late Wednesday night had reached the Jinning District on the edge of Kunming, a city of 7 million people that is the capital of Yunnan Province.